Victor.
Yeah, you're recorded. Now you are the host.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah, now you are recording. Right now you can continue the class. You can share the screen everything.
Yes, sure, sir. Sorry for the inconvenience. Yes, sir.
One minute.
Yeah, sure, sir.
Yeah, now you can continue.
Yes, sir. Sorry for the inconvenience. I was quite busy in other work. Good evening, one and all. Myself, Kiran. I did my floriculture. Hello, is this audible, na?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sure. Thank you. Yes, I'm a floriculture student. I'm specialized in the floriculture and landscape architecture. I'm presently working in the Indian Institute of Horticulture Research, Bangalore, ICRIHR Bangalore. I think you all well known this research institute. Today, I will cover in the brief of floriculture regarding the one of the most diverse flower in the floriculture sector, that is orchid. Just I will share my presentation. Now you all seeing my slide? Slide is visible, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, sure. Yes. In the floriculture, one of the most diverse flower is orchids. I will just brief out the crop related to this. We'll continue the orchids. Okay. Right. Welcome. With respect to the importance of this orchid, this is the most fascinating and beautiful among all the flowers. Then this... we have wide range of diversity in the flowers, around 2,500 species we can observe in the orchids, and it has an immense potential in the horticulture sector. And this, with respect to the commercial scale also, and with respect to the environment, it balances the forest ecosystem. Then with the cultivation of orchids, we can have the large scale cultivation of the orchids, which is a professional or like a profitable occupation right now. Then the pseudobulbs of Cymbidium and Dendrobium species are used as food. Then some of the orchid species are used as medicine, and some are for the ornamental purpose. And these orchids are commercially cultivated in the European countries, then USA, South American countries, Thailand, Singapore, Malaysia. These are well-known hotspots for the cultivation of these orchids. Then Japan, India, Sri Lanka nowadays. Then with coming to the family, these orchids belongs to Orchidaceae family. This is one of the largest family in the angiosperms. Over 800 genera are presented, and about 25 to 35,000 species are there. In India, about 180 genera of orchid species are existing. More than 80,000 hybrids in the single crop. You just imagine, in one single crop orchid, we can expect more than, now it's more than 1 lakh hybrids. With respect to the origin, this orchids belongs to tropical forests of Amazon and Indo-Malayan regions. With respect to distribution in India, we have southwestern Himalayas, around 200 species, and northeastern India, we have 800 species. Hello. Hello. Is this audible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Due to power cut, the Wi-Fi gone. Yeah, I can continue na. Right. I can continue now. You're listening, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes. Then coming to the tropical orchids. Tropical orchids are mostly cultivated in Thailand, Singapore, Malaysia. Temperate orchids are cultivated mostly in Japan, Korea, and Thailand. Then with respect to the botany, the floral biology of orchids. The among the flowers, the orchid flowers are unique with respect to the flowers. You see, these are the petals, these three petals. You can see the cursor moving. Any one of you can respond.
Yes, sir.
My cursor is moving. You can observe, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And these are the petals. These three are petals. These three are sepals. Usually in the flower, the sepals are usually green colored. Here in the orchids, these are also colorfully modified. With respect to the petals, the third petal is the lip or labellum, what we call. This is highly modified in the orchids. And these petals and sepals are fused. This is technically called as tepals. And here also you can observe the column or gynostrium. This is the female part of flower. Then the male and female parts are separated by the flip or projection of a tissue called rostellum. In between the male and female part, we can observe the rostellum. If you dissect the orchid flower, this is the physical barrier present in the orchid flower. On the stigmatic surface, these pollens are called as pollinia. In the orchids, this is a special term. You can note it down, because pollinia you can expect in the competitive exams like JRF and SRF, because this is a unique term. Pollinia belongs to which of the crop? Orchid, gerbera, like that. They can give the questions. Then the speciality of this orchid is the seeds are numerous. In the one capsule, around 3 lakhs seeds will be there. These are microscopic, tiny, and they lack the endosperm. This is the nutritive tissue in the seed. Then here also you can observe the lip modified in the orchid flowers. These are unique for every species. Every species also here you can observe this modified to attract the bees. These also you can observe. These are also modification. These are the different species. This is Dendrobium hybrid. Then with respect to the export potential, this can be, orchids are commercially exploited as cut flowers also, then potted plants also. Then we can export like tissue culture plants of orchids. Then these can be used as a medicinal orchids also to extract the alkaloids. And commercially, we are extracting the vanillin. This is highly commercialized product in the orchid. You can expect in the chocolates like this. Then pressed orchids also there. Then hybrids. Then with respect to the classification of orchids based on the habit. Based on the habitat, we can classify as terrestrial or ground orchids, which grow on the grounds. Then epiphytes. Epiphytes means which grow on the trees. Then saprophytic, lithophytic, and subterranean. Coming to the terrestrial or ground orchids, they only grow in the soil. These are usually sympodial and perennial. We will discuss these words. This is perennial and sympodial. For example, this is the roundelina. This is Spathoglottis. This is also ground orchid. Example. You can expect the questions like Spathoglottis belongs to which type of orchid? Terrestrial, lithophytic, epiphytic, terrarian. Like that, the questions may ask in the competitive exams like JRF and SRF. Then coming to the next one, epiphytic. Epiphytic means they grow on the other plants or the tree bark. They are abundant in the tropical rainforests of India. Means they will grow in the air. Like this, they will be floating in the air. Like they will be attached to the tree barks or other plant. They will support from the host tree. For example, Vandas, Vanillia, Dendrobium, then Cymbidium, Cattleya. These are all epiphytic orchids. They grow with the support of other plants, host tree. Saprophytic orchid means, saprophyte means what? living on the dead and decaying organic matter. Those are all called saprophytic orchids. Then lithophyte. Litho means rock or stone. These are rare and grown in the moist soils. Example, cymbidium. Coming to the subterranean orchids. These are the this is the fourth type of orchid. Subterranean means which grow underground the orchid. This grow underground the orchid found in the Australia. These are rare one. Then based on the ecological requirement, means climatic requirement, these are classified as tropical. Tropical loving orchids, then subtropical loving orchids. These are all mainly epiphytes. Then terrestrial also come. And mostly sympodial orchids. We'll discuss this one. Then temperate one. Based on the growth habit, monopodial and sympodial means how they grow. I feel all of you are listening well.
Yes,
yes,
sir.
Yes, yes.
Kiran sir.
Yes.
Kiran sir, you are recording the class, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
I am recording.
No, in the left side bottom, right side bottom, there is a switch called record. So you have to record in your computer.
Right. Yes, I started recording, but now the what is it? The notification has gone, I think.
Record notification will not be shown, but once you press record, it will be continuing to record. You have done that, no? That
yes.
is enough.
Yes, yes, sure.
Yeah. Oh, sorry to interrupt, sir. Continue.
Okay. Thank you. Then based on the growing habit, I said monopodial and sympodial. Monopodial means the single non-branching stem. It will grow like a single. It will not divide into multiple branches as we see in the normal trees or the plant. Example, vanda. Then sympodial means it will divide into multiple branches. Examples, dendrobium. And these are some of the commercially important genera. Phalaenopsis, I think you all well known of this orchid. This is also called as moth orchid, then vandas, then cattleya, dendrobium. Then this is also special, Phaphylophyllum. This is also frequently asked in the competitive exams. Like slipper orchid is also called as which genera, like this. Then foxtail orchid, this is also Rhynchostylis. This may also ask in the competitive exams. Then these are the some terminologies associated with the particular genera. Then coming to some important species like Eridis. This is epiphytic and monopodial. You can observe the single plant is growing upward, not branching. Here also you can observe. This is Eridis genera. Then this is Arachnis. This is very popular cut flower, also called as scorpion orchid. This flower resembles like scorpion. Hence they called as scorpion orchid. This common name also they can ask in the exams. Then this is Oscosanctum. Then this is Calanthe. This is ground orchid, exclusively grow in the soil. And this is Cattleya. This is sympodial. You can observe here the multiple branching of plant. This is called sympodial. This is Cymbidium. Cymbidium. This is also commercially cultivated in India, northeastern parts of Assam, Sikkim. Then this is Bulbophyllum. This is largest genera among the orchids. Among the flowering plants, orchid is the largest family. Within the Orchidaceae family, Bulbophyllum is the largest genera. Then these are all dendrobium hybrids you have seen in the nurseries and your college campus. Then this is Papilophyllum. You can observe this. This looks like lady slipper. In the European countries, the ladies will wear the slippers like this. So they named the common name like this. Then this is also ground orchid. The flowers look like a pigeon. Hence they are called as dove orchids. Then this is Phalaenopsis orchid. This is look like moth, white moth. Then this is vanda orchid. You see the single stem of the plant, but it won't divide. The flowers will appear after in the leaf axil. At every leaf axil, the flowers will appear. And one more specialty of this epiphytic orchids are, you can observe the roots were freely floating in the air, means they are exposed to air. The in the forest ecosystem, the main moisture and the with respect to the moisture and the nutrients will be absorbed through the roots. These specialized roots are called as velamen. It will consist of velamen tissues. It will absorb the moisture and the nutrients from the surrounding environment. Then some of the important varieties in the dendrobium species. Mainly in India, we commercially cultivate Sonia 17, 28. Then Emma White. And this is commercially cultivated in Kerala parts also. Then in orchids, the speciality is we can expect the intergeneric hybrids. Like we usually go for the interspecific hybridization in the normal breeding process. But in the orchids, we will go intergeneric. Between the genera, the hybridization work will be carried out. Among these, the Mokora is the highly commercialized intergeneric hybrids. These are all highly commercially cultivated in the greenhouses. Here you can observe this monopodial orchid. It will grow straight, single stem, and at every leaf axil, you will expect the flowering. Here you can observe the roots, aerial roots. Usually for the epiphytes, they go for the foliar spray with respect to the nutrition. This is ground orchid. This is also ground orchid. You just revise the, I will just brush up the with respect to the orchids. I think this much is not necessary for you guys, but you just go, this will be crazy. Like orchids are very beautiful, right? Then you can have a collection in your home. With respect to academic also, you can passionately cultivate in your home also. That's why I'm showing. This is also one of the famous hybrid in the orchid, Vanda. This is Oncidium. The specialty of this flower is, this flower resembles like a dancing lady. Hence the common name is dancing lady. Then this is vanilla. This is highly commercially cultivated for the extraction of vanillin. Then these are dendrobium hybrids. This is Sonia and Emma White. Then this is Bulbophyllum. These are highly modified flowers. Then this is Papilophyllum. Here it is, I have told you. Then with respect to the method of propagation, conventionally we go with respect to the monopodial, we go for the stem cuttings. Where they were possible, roots appear, where there we go for the stem cutting. Then we can also go for the flower stalk cutting also. Then air layering. Then in sympodial, division of clumps also expected. Then offshoot. This is the like a peculiar word given to the orchids. You can expect the questions like offshoots will appear in the orchids, or offshoot terminology will be associated with the orchids. Then back bulbs. These are all 1 year old spent out bulbs, shoots. Then with respect to the division, usually the sympodial orchids will follow. Then offshoots also called as kikis. This is also one of the botanical name given for the orchids. This is a peculiar word given for the kikis. Offshoots means these are the side shoots in the sympodial orchids like dendrobium. Then cutting also we can go for. Then with respect to the cultivation practices, these are the main factors which affects the cultivation of orchid, like temperature, humidity, light, aeration, and watering. With respect to the cultural intercultural operation, we can go for the potting, repotting, splitting and division, mass multiplication of the orchids, then fertilizer application, then plant protection, harvesting and handling. This repotting is exclusively done in the orchids. Then for the temperature, it will differ for the temperate orchids and tropical orchids and subtropical orchids. then some of the cool species will, some of the cool species like Cymbidium, they will survive in the 16 to 21 degrees Celsius. Some intermediate species like Cattleya, they will survive in 24 to 18 to 24 degree. Some warmer species like Phalaenopsis, they will survive in 21 to 29 degrees Celsius. With respect to the lightning, the orchids fall under the three groups. One is full sunlight requirement and intermediate exposure to sunlight, then fully shade. Some of the sun-loving orchids like Arachnis, Vandas are tropical species which they have to be cultivated in the full sunshine. Then partial shade requirement for the Dendrobiums. We'll go for the polyhouse cultivation or the greenhouse. These are the protective structures where we can cultivate the Dendrobiums or orchids. The cultivation, the structure is also called as Orchidorium. Then humidity is also one of the crucial factor which decides the healthy and growth of orchids. It should be range about 50 to 75%. Then watering, when to give, how to give, how much to give. It depends on the type of orchid, then type of pot, then potting media, and the position of shade house. Then fertilizer application, usually go for the organic fertilizers like cow dung, chicken manure, then groundnut cake, neem cake. But the media for the epiphytic orchids will be coconut husk, chips, then coir pith, sphagnum moss. This may also expect the questions like sphagnum moss is associated with the which crop, like that. Then with respect to the fertigation, you can go for the organic or inorganic fertilizers. And these are some of the products which used for enhancing the growth of the orchid. And this is a special orchid food given for the orchids for the healthy growth. Then with respect to the containers, for the terrestrial orchids, it is exclusively planted on the ground. For the epiphytic orchids, the containers will be like a wooden basket, coconut husk, tree fern, like sphagnum moss also, then chips of wood. These are the potting material used for the orchid cultivation. These are nut pots, community pots. These are the plastic vanda basket. The roots will be exposed in this basket, mainly used for the epiphytic orchids. Then you can see here the charcoal. Charcoal is used in the media to absorb the bad odor which generated by the fungi or the mosses grown in the media. Then coming to the potting media, the potting media used for the orchid cultivation mainly coir pith, peat moss, perlite, tree bark, ferns, then broken crocks, then sphagnum moss. These are all the potting media used for the cultivation. Then common mixture will consist of charcoal, I said, for the absorption of bad odor, then coconut husk to maintain the moisture, then dried tree fern roots, then sphagnum moss, this is also mainly for holding the moisture, then brix piece, then perlite. Then repotting usually done every 2 to 3 years, 3 years once. But for the epiphytes, every year we have to go for the repotting. Splitting and division of plants. If the clumps are more than, if they are crowded, at least more than 1 year, we have to go for the dividing of clumps. Like this, if it is too crowded in the pot, we have to divide and repot. Here also we can observe. These are the back bulbs. These are the spent out back bulbs, 1 year old, which already flowered and yielded. So they are called back bulbs. The structure we called as Orchidorium. For the cultivation of orchids, we call Orchidorium. And this is the system where the tray system above the ground, we will cultivate the some epiphytes. With respect to harvesting and handling, these dendrobiums, nowadays in India, we cultivate dendrobium at commercial scale. When it fully matured, we go for the harvesting there. After the harvesting, we go for the pre-cooling and we go for the preservative solutions like 300 ppm of 8-HQC and 5% of sucrose to improve the flower waste life and the quality. Then this is the harvesting stage and the storage and the waste life of different orchid species. Then the one of the speciality of these orchids, this the waste life of the orchids will extend up to 15 days to 1 month. If you left out in the plant itself, the waste life of the orchid flower will start from up. It will, the minimum days will be 15 days. Up to we can preserve 30 days in the plant itself. And this is the typical view of post-harvest room where the flowers are neatly staked after the cleaning. And this is the typical view of packaging system. After the cutout, we'll plug the cotton and the waste solution here. Then the bunches are made. Then coming to some of the pests and diseases in the orchid, major pest will be like a sucking pest, mites, scales, mealybugs. And the special cases will be slugs. These are typically attack the orchid plants, which will feed the leaves, flowers. Then how to control? I think you all well known with this, how to control the sucking pest. Symptoms also, I feel you all well known. With respect to important diseases, leaf spot, leaf blight, collar rot, these are the special important diseases in the orchid. This is the bacterial brown rot. If this bacteria attacks the orchid like Phalaenopsis, the foul smell will be emitted from the orchid. So you have to replace or you have to spray the bactericides. Then this is the bacterial rot caused by the Pythium and Phytophthora. Then these are the petal blight due to botrytis. This is the fungi. Thank you.
Anybody, any doubts?
Yeah, if you have any doubts, you can ask me. This is like just brush up of the one particular crop, orchid. I feel it's too lengthy to hear, but I have shown maximum of the photos. You can suggest me how to improve also, how to be your class.
Guys, this is your first floriculture class. So if you have read floriculture in your previous revision part or reading part, whatever, if you have any doubts, sir will clear it. So yes. You can ask any other doubts also, not only orchid.
Yeah, yeah. And you can suggest me the next crop also. Which one I have to take the next class?
If you students are not communicative, if you are not reading, if you are not doing anything, how much ever class anybody may take, nothing will help you. Try to speak, try to read. Okay. Sir has told a wonderful class, very good images. If you've been searching the images, it will be very difficult to search the images and read. No, now see, you have got everything compiled very beautifully. Nobody will join the class. Even I have mentioned today morning itself. When it is a doubt section, everybody will run away from the class also. Nobody is going to be in loss except you people. Your wish. I will share sir's number also. If you have any doubt, you can personally also ask, sir.
And also one more thing, ma'am. You put in the group, which will be the next class. You ask the students, which part they want to hear the next class, where they are like.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Definitely. Sure. They are not going to respond. We can end the class, sir. Thank you. You are the host, right?
Yeah, ma'am.
Yeah. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.